What happens if you delete System 32? I've won Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is going around again. This is one of those things that surprised me when I first heard it, for reasons you'll see in a moment. But people are being told, apparently, to delete System 32 because it's a virus, or for other reasons. Well, the fact is, System 32 is Windows. Deleting System 32 is essentially deleting Windows. So yes, there are people who probably consider Windows a virus. I'm not going to argue with them. But they are basically either trolling or pranking their friends into, essentially, destroying their Windows installation. So, what happens when you do it? Come with me as we delete System 32. So one of the first things I'm going to do is back up my C drive. The reason is very simple. I've done this before, and I'm going to need that backup to recover from the chaos. I'll just hit backup now. It's basically a simple backup of my entire C drive to my faux USB drive on this system. Whatever image backup you want to use is fine. I'm really not concerned about that. What's more concerning is that you somehow have an image backup, a complete backup of the drive on which you are about to do this. If you don't, then when all is said and done, you will be faced with reinstalling Windows from scratch. In other words, you're going to be doing a lot more work than you really need to. Naturally, while the backup is happening here, I'm going to emphasize that this is not something you should do. Do not delete System 32. It's a trap. People are trying to scam you. People are trying to fool you. People are trying to prank you. But I want to show you why, since I suspect a lot of folks are curious. So I'm going to go ahead and let the backup complete, and then we'll carry on. Okay, we have our image backup. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of Isis to do here because its job is done. Now, what's the best way to delete System 32? There's a question you never thought I'd ask. My approach to maximal destruction is to do this in the Windows Command Prompt Administrator mode. So I'm right-clicking here on Command Prompt, right-clicking on the Command Prompt that comes up, and clicking on Run as Administrator. Now you'll see we actually come up in the System 32 directory when you run as Administrator. System 32 has a lot of files. The last time I looked on this machine, I had something like 14,000 files across 3,500 directories. If I just do a DIR, just the top level, the stuff that's just in the System 32 directory without looking in the subdirectories, you can see it goes on and on and on. There's a lot here. So what I'm going to do to delete the contents is this. RD, which is technically remove directory, dot, which is the current directory, which basically means System 32, slash S, which means delete everything in the folder and all the subfolders and everything in the subfolders and so on and so on. Now, I'll hit return. Are you sure? Never has this question been more appropriate. But because I'm trying to cause destruction, I'm going to say yes. Now, as it goes through this process, it is generating a lot of errors. That's actually normal. A lot of the files are either in use by Windows itself, or they have some additional layer of protection. That's fine. On the other hand, a lot of things are being deleted as part of this. So you might think that things are normal. If I just exit and I've still got a start menu, I could probably still run something like Notepad. That's all great. Until we reboot. There you have it. We can't reboot. We've blue screened. There's actually nothing we can do at this point. Now, it will bring us to the recovery console here in a moment. And I've played some with the recovery console after having done this in the past. And it tries. The thing you might expect would work the quickest would be startup repair. But as it turns out, startup repair is unable to repair the startup. Really, the only solution at this point is to either restore your system from backup, as I will do after I'm finished with this video, or if you don't have that backup, reinstall Windows from scratch. So here we are, we're in, you know, couldn't start properly. We'll set up the recovery environment, hit F1. It needs to be repaired, can't do that. Yeah, it's not even allowing me to do some of those things, which is funny because it's actually worse than the last time I tried this. Not something I expected to be doing a lot of testing on. But the bottom line here is the machine won't boot. You've deleted System 32. You've basically damaged Windows so much that it can't start up. As I said, don't delete System 32. It's a trap. Regardless of whether you're about to delete System 32 or not, this is a great example of where an image backup saves your bacon, because the image backup that I took at the start of all this is what's going to allow me to continue to have a usable PC, basically right from where I left off. Hope this was interesting. Like I said, I hope you'll understand now why you really, really don't want to do it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/127295. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.